Hello and a very warm welcome to day one of the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games. Live action to look forward to here in Rio Centro, Pavilion 2. This is the main exhibition and convention centre located near Olympic Park. The atmosphere is hotting up, the crowds are in, and we're almost ready to start the women's 41 kilo category. Athletes, as I say this now, are warming up backstage and getting ready, putting the last preparations on their warm-up before they are called to the platform. For those of you new to the sport of powerlifting, athletes will be competing head-to-head in the bench press in a test to see, quite simply, who can lift the heaviest. Just over 3 minutes remaining on the countdown clock for the women's 41 kilo category. Athletes will only receive three attempts, and it's their top weight that counts. As with Olympic weightlifting, athletes are only categorised according to body weight. There's the weights they're going to be using. Big black ones, 50 kilos in weight. The red ones, 25. Blues are 20. Yellows, 15. And the greens are 10. In picture, your spotters. These guys will be adjusting the racks for every athlete. And in some cases, assisting the athlete off the racks, ready to start their first attempt. Here are some of the athletes preparing, putting the final preparations on their warm-up. They'll take 6, 7, 8 lifts, building up just from the empty bar, in which they'll start warming up, all the way up to a weight just below their openers. There's one of the hot favourites in picture right now, Zhe Cui of China. She has some serious credentials behind her. Two-time silver medalist from both London and Beijing Paralympic Games. Today's lineup includes your current Paralympic champion from London, Nazmiye Muratli from Turkey, and as mentioned, Zhe Cui of China. Big openers though from Nawal Ramadan, relatively inexperienced at this kind of level. The Egyptian coming in with 95 kilos. We've got three lifters also coming out around the 90 kilo mark, so it's going to be close. Could see some records broken here as well. Paralympic standard is 95 kilos. The world record of 103.5 kilos is held by the Chinese lifter that we are going to see shortly, Zhe Cui. So this is the lineup. Gives you the body weights as well. The lightest lifter is Noura Baddour of Syria. The heaviest, Nazmiye Muratli of Turkey. Body weight only comes into play if two lifters lift the same. The lighter lifter then takes the lead. So there's your world record, 103.5 kilos. Will we get close to that? Well, Nazmiye Muratli fancies her chances from Turkey. She's posted 102 as her opening attempt. And there are your referees. Three in the blue jacket in front in picture now. There's your jury. So the only people that can overturn decisions. So the three referees, you need a majority decision, at least two must agree for a referee to be either good or bad. Lots of things to look out for in powerlifting, but I'll try and point them out as we go. So you can hear the announcer asking for 80 kilos to be loaded to the bar. This will bring out Leidy Rodriguez of Cuba for her first attempt. In para-powerlifting, once the bar is loaded and the athlete has been called, lifters will have 2 minutes on the clock. Gives them sufficient time to make their way to the platform. And if required, to have the legs strapped to the bench. And you see Leidy Rodriguez tapping her arms, giving herself a slap, otherwise known as tapotement in the massage world. Stimulating to make sure she's ready and in the zone. Well, Some lifters prefer the coaches to take responsibility for the straps, but here, Leidy Rodriguez, quite capable of doing it herself. Clearly knows how she likes the positioning. Having trained and competed in wheelchair basketball and sitting volleyball, Leidy Rodriguez has since 2011 turned her attention to powerlifting. Relatively unknown at the moment. Let's see what she can do here. 80 kilos, first attempt. Well, it looks comfortable. As with everything, we need to wait for the referee's decision. They agree. Three white lights, and that sure looked easy. No assistance required. Quite happy to take the bar off the racks on her own. The bar must lower to the chest under control. Pause momentarily before being driven back to arm's length. Key things to watch out for. The level of the bar, it must remain constant. Cannot have one arm coming up quicker than the other. Textbook lifting from Leidy Rodriguez of Cuba, successful with 80 kilos. A smile that she's happy or a smile that she's relieved. So loaders, as you can see, just adjusting the racks. Each lifter will have the racks set to their required height. That's dependent on the length of their arms. There are marks on the bar, small circles just outside the shoulder width mark. Lifters are allowed to have their hands on the mark, but not outside. They must be either on or inside those marks. There's no requirement as to how narrow you can go. There is a limit to how wide you can go. So, onto the stage, Noura Baddour of Syria. 31-year-old, personal best of 85 kilos. Just indicating to the referees her elbow lock and showing that they don't lock out properly. So clock is ticking, just below 1:30, taking a minute. Coach says, come on then, let's do it. Noura Baddour from Syria, first attempt, 87 kilos. Well, very aggressive in the manner she's lifting. She's got it, 2-1. In fact, there's one red light, doesn't matter, so long as it's a majority decision. Just to put this in perspective, that's 2 kilos above the weight she lifted back in 2014 to place fifth at the World Championships. Really aggressive, driving the bar back to arm's length. Spot, as you can see, with her hands linked underneath the bar just in case there's a problem. And they won't touch it unless the centre referee instructs them to do so.
Thank you. The bar is limited to 88 kilograms. First attempt. Maryna Kopiika. Lifter to follow. Indonesia, Widiasih.
Prepara
Widiasih. Just waiting. I think Maryna Kopiika of the Ukraine has been called. Yes, she has, making her way very slowly though. Clock is on, 1:30 already. Already a Paralympian from London, where she placed seventh. She's demonstrated improvements on the world stage by finishing sixth at the World Championships in 2014 with 82 kilos. That is her current best, coming in here at 88. So clearly training has gone well. Clearly she's done more in preparation. See, setting up in position, just arching her back, gets the chest as high as possible. Quite simply, that means there's less distance for the bar to travel. That's allowed, as long as the shoulders, hips, head and feet remain in contact with the bench. Very strong lifting. But it's been failed, 2-1 against. A couple of things to look out for. Any movement on the chest is not allowed. And also the bar must stay level on its way up. Downward movement looked good. Didn't see any movement on the chest. Maybe her left arm coming up slightly ahead of the right. Very, very strict refereeing. But hey, the rules are the rules. Frustration there. And she realises the decision. That's a wasted attempt.
First attempt from Indonesia, Ni Nengah Widiasih.
Ni Nengah Widiasih of Indonesia, 23-year-old. Finished just outside the medals in London, fifth place. She's shown considerable improvement, though, to place third at the World Championships in 2014 with 93 kilos. That was 15 kilos up from London. How much further can she go here? Well, she's already starting on 95. Coach is giving the final instructions to the central spotter. Lifters are allowed assistance to unrack the bar. Coach just allowing Widiasih a moment to compose herself and put final thoughts together. Taking her hands pretty much as wide as she dare without going outside those marks on the bar. Choosing to use both of the straps. That helps the athlete keep the lower part of the body in contact with the bench. Well, was that level? Let's wait for, see what the referees think. They think not. It's getting to a point where we almost need a spirit level on the bar. Shrugging the shoulders as if to say, I'm not sure what was wrong with this. Goes down nicely, pauses. Her right arm comes up before her left. I think that's what the referees have failed it on. Small shake of the head in frustration. These lifters are only permitted three attempts. They need to make one count to be in the competition. Discussion now about whether she takes the same weight again or chooses to go up in the second round. Once the lifters have nominated their weight, that's it, they can't change it. Only in the third and final round do they have two opportunities to change. Coming onto the platform now, Nawal Ramadan of Egypt. 24-year-old, relatively unknown quantity at this level. This will be her first Paralympic Games. Recent results include finishing fourth at the World Championships in 2014 with 87 kilos. Clearly she's improved since then. 95 kilos is the weight she has opted for. Well, bravo is what's being shouted by the coach. I'm not sure the referees are going to agree. Was that level? No, I don't think so. Has to be one of the most frustrating sports, and the lifter is clearly strong enough. It's not just about strength, it's about control. The bar has to be perfectly level. There you can see her left arm kicking in faster than her right. The bar was uneven on its way up, no lift. Well, here we go, 96 kilos on the bar. This could be an attempt at a Paralympic record for the athlete from China, who is also the current world record holder, Zhe Cui, 29 years of age, two-time silver medalist. How frustrating from both London 2012 and Beijing 2008 Paralympics. Has ambitions here to go one better. Starting big. In London, she finished with 97 kilos. Here she's opening with 96. Nickname, Powerful Beauty. Is this going to be a powerful, aggressive lift? Well, look how wide her hands are. Really uses the full width of the bar. What do the referees think? Great lifting. There we go. There's a new Paralympic record, 96 kilos. Problem is, how long will it stand for? We still have two lifters yet to start this competition. Well, this is going to get exciting. Nice lifting. There's your current leader. Coach looks happy, the clap, but no smile. Only that will come at the end of the event. A couple of discussions now, what weight do you want? I think that hand shrug was a whatever I need. Put it on the bar. This is going to be a fiercely competitive sport for the medals. The bar looks to be going up to 101. Just 2.5 kilos below the current world record. And again, if successful, this will be a new Paralympic record. Nsini Ben of Nigeria, just 19 years of age, so young, but so inexperienced. No international results, so stepping straight up onto the biggest platform of all. She's the youngest in the group. Asking the coach to readjust the strapping, needs to be comfortable. This is to keep the legs in place. See, the bench is a lot wider than most benches you would find in gyms. Obviously narrower at the top, so the elbows have clearance on the way down. Wow, she's choosing a very, very close grip. The closer the hands, the more triceps are involved. The wider the hands, the more chest. Well, it went up only just. The referee's happy with it. No, they're not. And this is where the inexperience may come into play. You'll see 90% plus of these lifters opting for a very wide grip. It makes it shorter distance for the bar to travel. That looks good. Okay, dips into the chest quite a long way. That may be deemed as advantageous. Has to work hard through the sticking point. Barm has touched the chest, but not allowed to sink into it. Let's have a look at the level of the bar as well. Bar tips on the way up. Could have been failed on two accounts there. So yeah, most lifters will go for the hands nice and wide because it's less distance for the bar to travel. Also brings in more of the chest muscles. The closer your hands are, the further the bar has to go, and the more it brings in the triceps. Obviously, all of those muscle groups are used regardless of where your hands are. It does affect the extent to how much each muscle group is used. Well, the only lifter remaining in this first round is Turkey's Nazmiye Muratli. She was the first woman under 41 kilo body weight to lift over 100 kilos. First competed in the Paralympic Games in Beijing, finishing fourth. Went all the way in London, though, to take gold with a huge 106 kilos. She has ambitions here to retain her title. She's going to be very, very tough to beat. So, 102 kilos, first attempt. New Paralympic record, if successful. Okay, the referee's happy with the level of the bar. Yes, they are, and there we go, new Paralympic record. And a cheeky smile, she's happy with that. Still two attempts remaining, and doesn't she look strong? Well, does she have what it takes to retain her title from London? Touches the chest, pauses, comes up beautifully straight. That's the way to do it. There's your textbook lifting, as discussed. Hands nice and wide, less distance for the bar to travel. They don't want us to hear what's going on. Clearly discussing choice of weight for the second attempt. Athlete and coach must have a good relationship in this sport. And they would have discussed opening weights, potential second, third attempts, different scenarios that might occur. As the coaches are on a bit of a time limit. Once the lifter is off the platform, they only have a minute to make that decision. So, round two, here we go. Back to Leidy Rodriguez of Cuba, 85 kilos now on a second attempt, successful with 80 on the first. This to increase by 5, won't move her up the positions. This is more about experience for Rodriguez than for medals. Again, very strong lifting, and unfortunately this time failed 2-1. Referees have seen an infringement. I was with the referee that gave it. Was that uneven? Really need a straight angle to be able to give a good decision, but hey, I'm only commentating, I'm not refereeing. She's clearly strong enough for the weight. Let's hope on a third attempt she can nail it. Discussion again, what do you want next? You. Stay on the same or go up? Nothing to lose, I guess. So we've got a change in order of lifters in the second round. The order is determined by the weight that the athletes select for their attempt. lightest weight first, and the bar is then rising throughout the round. Second attempt now for Maryna Kopiika of Ukraine. Ukrainian powerlifting coach visited an orphanage where she lived and encouraged her to try powerlifting. In her own words, she fell in love with the people and the gym and the work that they did. These people have a mission in life to help each other achieve it. She said, I got the feeling I was finally part of a family. Well, part of another family now, the Paralympic family. What do the referees think? They've given it three white lights after missing in her first attempt, successful in her second. She's safely in the competition.
Loaders, please load the bar now to 90 kilograms. Rack height. 7.
Anilheiros, por favor, montar a barra com 90 quilos e a altura do rack 7.
Thank you. The bar is loaded. 90 kilograms. For the second attempt, from Syrian Arab Republic, Noura Baddour.
Barra pronta com 90 quilos para a segunda tentativa de Baddour na Síria.
Lifter to follow.
One attempt remaining. We've got a thumbs up. Let's wait and see how far she can go on a third. And onto the platform now, Noura Baddour of Syria, a 31-year-old. Already surpassed her previous best of 85 with her opening attempt of 87. Chosen just for 3 kilo increase on her second attempt. Indicating, reminding the referees her elbows don't lock out. Well, I'm not sure the referees are going to like that. Very strong. Was it level? I don't think so. Well, the referees have given it. There's 2-1.
Loader, please load the bar now to 95 kilograms. Rack height 9.
Anilheiros, por favor, carregar a barra com 95 quilos e a altura do rack.
A glance there straight away to the scoreboard. Clearly pleased with her second attempt, 90 kilos. That's a big personal best for Noura Baddour of Syria. Great lifting.
Thank you. Bar is loaded to 95 kilograms for the second attempt from Indonesia. Ni Nengah.
So we're now warming up to the top end of the field where the medals are going to be decided. Can Ni Nengah Widiasih of Indonesia move herself up the board? Failed on her first attempt with 95 kilos. Was chosen to take the same weight again. This may well limit how far she's able to progress in the competition. Widiasih has ambitions of winning medals at the 2016 Paralympic Games here in Rio. Fear she may find herself just outside. Needs to execute this second attempt.
Stop.
Well, it's strong, it really is. I feel that she can lift another 10 kilos on top of that. It's a good lift this time, 2-1. That's what she wanted. How much further is she able to go on a third attempt? If she wants a chance of a medal, she's going to have to go big.
95 kilograms.
Clearly very, very strong.
Rackout is 11.
Impairment is a result of the effects of polio contracted at the age of 3. These powerlifters are stronger than able-bodied counterparts of the same body weight. And that is pretty much applicable across the board in all of the weight categories here. Tremendous degree of strength shown from these athletes. So as with Widiasih, we have Nawal Ramadan of Egypt. The 24-year-old has failed her first attempt on 95, sensibly opted to stay on the same weight. Three attempts in the bench discipline. It's not the weight you start on that's important, it's the weight you finish on. She has started extremely heavy. Didn't pay off on the first attempt, needs to execute this now to have a chance of a medal. I don't know, was that good enough? Again, did the right, her left arm, or our right as we look at it, go up quicker? Well, the referees are having issues with this, and so is Ramadan. Just a bit too keen with the right arm, needs to slow it down. It's dropping into the chest as well. It's a clear failure, the rules are the rules. The lifters know that. They train for it, but when you're under pressure, it's a different story. Almost a little too quick to the bottom, bit of a dip off the chest. Definitely uneven at the top. So two failures, only one attempt remaining to stay in this competition. Not just any competition, Paralympic Games. There's your leaderboard. Nazmiye Muratli of Turkey, 102. That's the weight to beat at the moment, and that's only a kilo and a half off the world record.
Zhe Cui, Republic, People's Republic of China.
Prepara Zhe Cui da China.
So again, we've got a change of order of athletes. Nsini Ben of Nigeria, the youngest lifter in the field. As we saw from her first attempt, so strong. The referees failed it, they saw an infringement. Needs this bar to travel upwards, keeping it nice and level. No. Bar started to go back down. Centre referee calls for it to be re-racked. Well, Nsini Ben of Nigeria now finds herself in a spot of bother. Two failures. Needs her final attempt to remain in the competition. Bar can stop, but it can't go back down. As soon as that happens, the referee will ask for the bar to be re-racked. And that's the spotter's job to step in. You can see them on the ends of the bar just following it, just in case they're needed.
Thank you. Bar is loaded to 102 kilograms.
Oh, you've got to wonder what's going through her mind right now. The frustration, the disappointment of having missed two attempts, needs to put that behind her. So here we go. Bar is up to 102. If successful, this will put Xia Zhe of China ahead of her rival from Turkey by virtue of lighter body weight. 102 was the heaviest weight lifted from the first round. This to take the lead. 102. It won't be a record. Initially involved in para badminton, however, took up powerlifting because her partner switched to the sport. Sure, didn't have anybody to play with. She has a great philosophy. Persistence in pursuing your dreams makes things better. Well, she's got a dream to pursue. Is that good enough? Yes, it is. There's your leader. 102 puts her into lead by virtue of lighter body weight. She'll take that. Thank you very much. Loaders, more weight, please. Well, tremendous lifting from the Chinese athlete. And if you could hear that back home, the announcers have asked for a 104 to be loaded for the next attempt.
Thank you. The bar is loaded by 104 kilograms for the second attempt from Turkey.
So 104 is the weight that has been requested. If successful, will be a new world record. She would take the world record away from Zhe Cui of China, who we've just seen. This is a huge ask. Looked very strong on the first attempt. So, to retain her Paralympic title in Rio is her ambition. Her impairment is a congenital hip dislocation. Well, it's certainly not affecting her ability to bench. Nazmiye is somewhat of a para-athlete legend back home in Turkey after winning gold 4 years ago. Well, can she be a double legend? The next few seconds are about to determine that. World record, Paralympic record at stake, 104 kilos on a second attempt. Well, how easy did that look? So comfortable. There's the smile, there's the relief. Back into the lead. A new world record. It doesn't seem to faze her. Why? Because she still has one attempt remaining. And she's still being pushed to the limit. Fantastic lifting, great control to the chest, pauses, drives back to arm's length. Paralympic record, world record, 104 kilos. And just remember, these girls are only weighing sub 41. Tremendous strength in the upper body. Very few guys that can do that at that body weight. So that concludes second round. Round three, here we go. Leidy Rodriguez of Cuba. third and final attempt. She's gone 80 first attempt, missed 85. What the heck? Gone to 88 for a third and final attempt. Nothing to lose, but a position to gain. This would put her, if successful, ahead of the Ukrainian Maryna Kopiika by virtue of lighter body weight. Last words of advice from the coach. Come on, you've got this. Oh, it's still moving. Do the referees deem that to have been level? Need a majority decision. And unfortunately, it's a majority against. Centre referee gave it. I thought I saw movement, but she's probably in the best position.
Voters, please load the bar to 92 kilograms.
Well, did well to keep pushing through the sticking point. Didn't allow the bar to stop moving. It's a good attempt, not to be. She's left back with 80 kilos. It's going to finish well down in eighth place. I say eighth place, could pick up a few positions if one or two of these lifters are unable to execute their third and final attempts.
Thank you. Tomorrow's loaded to 92.
Good learning curve
for the third attempt.
For Rodriguez.
From Syrian Arab Republic, Noura Baddour.
So Noura Baddour of Syria had a great lift with 90 kilos on her second attempt. It looked like a limit, didn't look like there was much more there, and quite sensibly has opted for 92 on a third attempt. Personal best, remember, coming into these Paralympic Games was 85 kilos. Indicating to the referees, just a reminder, my elbows don't lock. Biggest influence in her life, her mother. Oh, so strong. That looked better than the previous attempt. And she's got it. Three from three. Now we're going to see the big smiles. Now she can go away and celebrate. Great lifting. Congratulations. Cannot ask for any more. Three good lifts on the biggest sporting stage of all and personal bests to boot. Thoroughly deserved. Universal language for I'm happy. So far now up to 95 kilos. These are your current standings. In gold medal position so far, Nazmiye Muratli of Turkey. China in second. Widiasih of Indonesia in third. Not too far behind, we've got Noura Baddour of Syria. He's close at the top. we could see more records yet.
Nawal Ramadan.
Barra pronta com 95 quilos para a terceira tentativa de Ramadan do Egito. Prepare-se, Kopiika, da Ucrânia.
So Noura Ramadan, 95 kilos, third and final attempt. She's missed her first two, needs this to stay in the competition. Needs this to get a result. This is what you call a pressurized lift. Never a nice position to be in. Clearly strong enough, but she must keep that bar level on the way up.
1 minute.
That's what the referees will be looking for. Better. What do the referees think this time? Third time lucky. Oh, or not. Wow. She's asking the questions. What was wrong? You can see the frustration and the disappointment. She fancied her chances of contending for the medals. Well, it was better. Not good enough. 2-1 against, no lift. She's out of the competition. Well, here we go. This is the appeals procedure. Different to weightlifting. Just check, are they definitely appealing? I believe they have a minute to appeal. You have to pay 100, I think it's 100 euros as well. I think we're going to see an appeal from the Egyptians. It has to be in writing and with a monetary value as well. Competition doesn't stop. Dear. So Maryna Kopiika of the Ukraine, unsuccessful with her third attempt. It's a shame, she's left back on 88 kilos. That was a big increase, trying to get back in contention. Wasn't to be. At least she's got a total lift registered. Bouncing on the chest, not strong enough to get it moving again. Well, she can afford a smile now. That's job done. Nothing else that can be done.
Thank you. Tomorrow's loaded to 100 kilograms for the third attempt. From Indonesia, Ni Nengah Widiasih.
So, third and final attempt now for Ni Nengah Widiasih of Indonesia.
Lifter to follow.
Her impairment is a result of the effects of polio contracted when she was young. Big ambitions in the future in this sport, and she's in a really good position right now. This won't be good enough for the medals. 100 kilos. It's a big milestone in any athlete's career. She's using this time to compose herself, gather her thoughts, go through her own mental preparation. Coach is respecting that. Now time for business.
1 minute.
Some athletes like to wait for the minute buzzer so it doesn't interfere with their mental preparation. Bar continued to move, didn't go back down. Do the referees think it was level? No, they don't. Well, that's a shame. Left back on 95 kilos. It was a gutsy effort not to beat today. And you can just see how strict the refereeing is. What's the point in having rules if you don't stick to them? Slightly uneven as the bar comes back. Her left arm leading. Slightly quicker than the left, than the right. My left's my right. You know when you're looking at somebody and it's all backwards. So on our right of the screen, that arm comes up slightly quicker. There, the bar tips, and that's enough for it to be failed.
Thank you. The bar is loaded to 101 kilograms. For the third attempt from Nigeria, Ben Nsini.
Barra pronta, 101 kilos. Para a terceira tentativa de Ben Nsini.
Shrug of the shoulders, the disappointment. She can do another set now, drop down set, maybe on 70 kilos. So we have Nsini Ben of Nigeria, 19-year-old, again under serious pressure right now. Started her Paralympic campaign with 101, failed on her first and second attempt. Seriously needs this now to stay in the competition. If successful, could put her up into a medal position, but she has to get this. Nowhere to run, nowhere to hide. All or nothing on this final attempt. More level. What do the referees think? Is this enough for a medal? Oh my goodness me. How close can you get? They appeal as well. I don't know. Serious disappointment right there. Strong enough. Technically not good enough. Now this sport isn't just about brute strength. A bit more to it than that. Some of you back home that do bench as part of your training, you know, try and do it as strict as we're seeing here. It's difficult. Tears, we've got upsets, the realization of what's just happened. It can be a killer sometimes.
You
prepare so much for something and it all goes horribly wrong. Nothing you can do.
From the People's Republic of China, Zhe Cui.
Bah, pronta. 105 kilos. Terceira tentativa de Zhe Cui.
So, bronze medal has been decided. Ni Nengah Widiasih of Indonesia. Successful with 95 kilos on her second attempt. That's enough for the bronze. Now we have a battle for gold and silver. Coming onto the platform. China's Zhe Cui. Her ambition to win Olympic gold here after finishing second in London and Beijing Paralympics. Desperately wants to take the gold. Persistence in pursuing your dreams. Well, she is being persistent. She's taken the knockbacks with a pinch of salt and she's here to fight again. needs this. Currently in silver medal position. This would take her into the lead and is another attempt at the world and Paralympic record, 105 kilos. This is bigger than anything she's done before. Can she execute here? No. Sport has had to intervene. No. What a shame. I mean, what does she need to do? Three times now, three successful Paralympic Games. She finishes in second place. She's still smiling. Must be asking, what does she need to do? She breaks world records, she sets Paralympic Games records, and it's still not good enough. So there's your silver medalist, China's Zhe Cui. One lifter remaining. So here we go, huge weight now, 106 kilos. Nazmiye Muratli of Turkey, 37 years of age. She was the first woman to go over 100 kilos at this very light body weight of sub 41. She was a gold medalist 4 years ago where she lifted this weight. Can she do it again? She's already the champion. She's already a sporting icon, a sporting legend back home in Turkey. Well, this to take it one step further. 106 kilos. World record, Paralympic Games record. Strong is that? What do the referees think? That looked good to me. Oh, they're not going to give it to her. Well, goodness me. She still is the world record holder, Paralympic record holder, Paralympic gold medalist. What an accolade of achievements. Incredible performance, incredible strength. Sub 41 kilo body weight. Those weights are immense. I challenge any female to go out and get even close to that. That is huge. She would have spent many, many hours in the gym together, training and getting ready for this moment. And there's your winner, Nazmiye Muratli of Turkey. Thoroughly deserves the gold medal, 104 kilos. She's saying, should have done more. There's going to be some celebrations later. Yes, we represent Turkey. Well done. And here are the final results in the women's sub 41 kilo category. Your winner from Turkey, Nazmiye Muratli, 104 kilos. Silver medalist from China, Zhe Cui, 102 kilos. And in bronze medal position from Indonesia, Ni Nengah Widiasih, tremendous lifting. And Noura Baddour, well, she came close. We'll have to settle for fourth. The crowd clearly enjoyed the women's 41 kilo category. What a way to start these Paralympic Games. Some tremendous lifting by all athletes. I'm sure we're going to see some of them back in 4 years' time. Turkey, quite rightly so, take top honours. Their athlete, Nazmiye Muratli, 37 years of age, just proves that anything is possible. Now crowned as double Paralympic champion. So here we go, the medal ceremony, the Rio 2016 Paralympic women's 41 kilo category, para powerlifting. What a tremendous start to these Paralympic Games we've had. Three athletes in picture that thoroughly deserve the medals they are about to be presented with.
Governing board member smiling of the International Paralympic
and enjoying the moment. Great
as
to see.
Bernard
Bourguignard, IPC, governing board member, will be presenting the awards.
Accompanied by Director Ticketing, Rio 2016.
Acompanhado pelo diretor de
ticketing,
senhor
Donovan Ferretti. It's great to see that the crowd that have been in Rio Centro Pavilion 2 made this event special.
Medalha
for
de
the
bronze
athletes
representando a Indonésia,
Ni Nengah Widiasih.
Ni Nengah Widiasih, bronze medalist from Indonesia, finished just outside the medals in London. Shown consistent improvement and has clearly worked hard ahead of these games. How much further might she be able to go? Another 4 years maybe? Well, at the age of 23, we'd like to think so. Missed 95 kilos on her first attempt, then executed, missed 100 on third and final attempt. It wouldn't have been enough to increase the bronze medal position. The silver medalist, Xia Zhe of China, the age of 29, never the fairy tale ending. Three times now silver medalist, Beijing 2008, London 2012, and now here in Rio 2016. The philosophy, persistence in pursuing your dreams makes things better. Well, she's going to need to pursue for another 4 years if she wants to step up from the silver.
Medalha de ouro, campeã paralímpica, representando a Turquia.
Nazmiye Muratli.
Paralympic champion in the women's 41 kilo category. Nazmiye Muratli of Turkey. Accepting the medal graciously. Clearly happy with the victory, clearly happy with the World Paralympic Games record that she has also set. Tremendous feat of strength, well in excess of double point, 2.5, in excess of 2.5 times body weight. Truly remarkable achievement.
Senhoras e senhores, o hino da Turquia.
Ladies and gentlemen, the Paralympic medalist.
Well, she was named as the 2014 Sports Person of the Year, the Okan University Sports Awards in Istanbul. Muratli was named 2014 Best Physically Impaired Athlete of the Year. She was Turkey's flag bearer at the closing ceremony in the London Paralympic Games. And a sports facility has already been named after her. Further achievements this remarkable athlete achieve going forwards. competition is over. The tensions will turn to the celebrations. A long line of interviews that will be required. Protocol of anti-doping. It's going to be a late, late night. Some tremendous lifting here in Rio Centro Pavilion 2. We've been spoilt with the Paralympic Games records, with world records. We've seen medals awarded to some outstanding athletes. This concludes the women's 41 kilo category from Rio Centro Pavilion 2 at the Rio 2016 Paralympic Games.
Thank you.